And back at Market Square, Austin Pete Pritchett is the coach of Bedford-North Lawrence. The Stars are in the championship game. They've won 21 consecutive basketball games, lost only to Jeffersonville during the entire season. And there's a big one coming up here tonight for Coach Pete. And Pete, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Hilliard. There certainly is a big ball game here tonight.
Well, it was an uphill battle this afternoon for you.
Oh, definitely. We led one time, I think, there in that last quarter, and that was the last 8 seconds.
What did you tell your team late in the ball game? What did you change? How did you get back into the ball game? You were down by 4 or 5 late in the contest.
Well, I felt like we were getting the shots, and I know we missed a couple of layups, just breakaway layups. And, you know, when you're getting that type of play, you feel like, well, it'll break in a minute. You know, we're going to make something happen. And we just kept packing away and kept working on it, and the girls never gave up. And they gave their all, and here we are.
What's the key to tonight's game?
Well, I think you can see that we're not a big ball club. And we have two girls that's been doing the rebounding about all year. And if we can reasonably stay with them on the board, well, then we will be in the ball game all night long.
Haven't had a lot of rest.
No, we haven't. It seems like we do more traveling in our vans than we do get to sit and rest a while.
Well, Pete, congratulations making it to the championship game. Best wishes to you here.
Thank you very much, Owen. It's great to be here.
Now let's talk to Tom May, the coach of Crown Point that eliminated the defending state champions here this afternoon. This is our third time in a couple of days talking to this coach, but we congratulate you again. You had more rest, but I noticed you had your team here for at least the first half of the second game.
Yes, well, we had already talked about it before. We came down here with the idea to enjoy ourselves. We wanted the girls to have some fun, and we also wanted to really understand what the state finals was all about and being a part of it. And being back in a hotel room thinking about what can go wrong or can go right at night is not my idea of fun. So we decided to stay for a little bit.
Coach, you had the inside game, you had the outside game today. Erickson outside, and you had Hammel on the inside.
Yes. Well, obviously, Heritage elected to keep the ball away from our guards or at least contain their shooting. They did, but at the same time, when they took that away from us, they had to give us something else, and that was namely Erickson on the weak side wing and Hammel low, and those two had probably two of the better games this year.
Quickly now, what are you going to change from the Heritage game to Bedford-North Lawrence tonight?
Well, a lot of things, simply because what Bedford does. Bedford is a man-to-man playing team, I should say woman-to-woman. And so we're going to have to totally adjust from our zone offense into a woman-to-woman offense. And I think it's going to open up some opportunities for our guards because we have the opportunity and the ability to get it to our guards and isolate them a little bit.
Well, Coach, congratulations again and best wishes in the championship game here tonight.
Thank you very much.
Tom May, the coach of Crown Point, back in a moment.
The towering symbols of the great state of Indiana, the Soldier and Sailor's Monument on the circle in the heart of downtown Indianapolis. And the shadows of that landmark, a bustling city, made even more so tonight as we look west down Market Street, the Market Square Arena, the site of the 1982 Girls State High School Basketball Championship. And this is the inside of Market Square Arena. Over 12,000 fans are on hand for the 1983 edition of the Girls Championship of State High School Basketball as the Crown Point Bulldogs, 22-4 on the year, take on the Bedford-North Lawrence Stars at 25-1. And hello again, everybody. Delighted to have you along tonight for the State High School Basketball Championship. The Crown Point Ball Club defeated the Heritage this afternoon, the defending state champions. What that does, it assures for the 8th consecutive year that we will not have a defending champion back in the championship game to take home that championship trophy twice in a row. Crown Point a winner, 57-49, as Tammy Hammel had 23 points and 10 rebounds. She's a 6-foot senior forward who played so very well this afternoon. Bedford North Lawrence, what a tussle they had with Thomas Carhowe High School of Indianapolis. It looked for all the world as though Howe would take home the winning margin this afternoon and play for the trophy tonight. That did not happen because Tina Boruff came up with 16 points, the 5'5 senior guard, as they defeated Howe 47-46. Great crowd on hand. Should be a great basketball game tonight. Crown Point and Bedford North Lawrence. Back at the opening tip-off of the starting lineups in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. says it all of sport. There's nothing quite like the championship game, regardless of what particular sport it might be. Football, baseball, track, basketball. And that's where we are tonight. Market Square Arena for the Girls State High School Basketball Championship. And with tonight's pregame ceremonies, let's go across the floor now to our public address announcer, Scott Gray.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The Indiana High School Athletic Association welcomes you to Market Square Arena in Indianapolis for the championship game of the 8th annual Indiana High School Athletic Association Girls State Basketball Tournament. Our championship game tonight features the Bedford-North Lawrence Stars against the Crown Point Bulldogs. We ask that you now please rise for the presentation of our colors. Tonight, the colors will be presented by the renowned Irish Guard of Greenwood High School under the direction of Miss Pam Smith. The Irish Guard is the defending 1982 state military champion and also holds the 1979 National All-American Military title. Ladies and gentlemen, the Irish Guard from Greenwood High School.
Standing, our national anthem this evening will be sung by the Windsors from Warren Central High School in Indianapolis. The Windsors are under the direction of Mr. Phil Dunn.
a simply splendid presentation of the colors and singing of our national anthem just prior to tonight's high school basketball championship game. We'll be back at Market Square Arena in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank.
Testing, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Not that I know of, no. Let's take a look at a couple of the young ladies who played so very well this afternoon. First point for Crown Point, number 35, Tammy Hammel, a 6-foot senior. She had 23 points in the afternoon game, 9 of 14 from the field, 5 of 7 out of that free throw line, and 10 rebounds. She was just sensational all day long. For the Bedford North Lawrence Stars, who now go 25-1, number 21, Tina Boruff, a 5'5 senior, played very well today. Shot most of her shots from outside the top of the free throw circle from 16, 18 feet away. She had 16 points and 6 out of 15 from the floor. 4 out of 4 free throws, pulled down 1 rebound, but all afternoon long, she was the outside scoring threat. So we're set to go now with the championship game here at Market Square Arena. Let's once again go across the floor to Scott Gray.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's now time for the announcing of our starting lineups for tonight's championship game. Here are the starting lineups. First, for the visiting Bedford North Lawrence Stars. At one guard, a 5'5" junior, number 21, Tina Bora.
Well, you just saw Tina. She had 16 points this afternoon. She averages 13.8 tops on the ball club.
At the other guard, a 5'3" senior, number 43, Kelly Fitzgerald.
This is the young lady that hit that all-important free throw with 14 seconds to go to get that win for Bedford North Lawrence this afternoon.
At one forward, a 5'10" junior, number 23, Sherry Farrell.
Sherry averages 11.8. She was the top rebounder of this afternoon's game with 8.
At the other forward, a 5'6" senior, number 33, Luann Sargent.
With an average of 7.2, she outdid herself. She had 8 points this afternoon.
And at center, a 5'10" senior, number 41, Bobbi Jo Lovell.
Top rebounder was 7.5 a game. She had 6 today and 3 points to go along with it.
The coach of the Bedford North Lawrence Stars, Pete Pritchett.
Pete Pritchett, in his first year, now 25-1. What a tremendous season he's had.
And now the starting lineup for the home team tonight, the Crown Point Bulldogs. At one guard, a 5'5" junior, number 12, Nancy Cowan.
Nancy scored 9 points today. She's the top regular season scorer with an average of 18.5 a game.
At the other guard, a 5'9" sophomore, number 14, Ann Kavachkov.
Averaging 14.2, she had 6 points and 7 assists today.
At one forward, a 6-foot senior, number 35, Tammy Hammel.
Well, what a great game she had. 23 points and 10 rebounds.
At the other forward, a 5'9" junior, number 40, Merritt Erickson.
In that victory over Heritage, Merritt had 16 points and 3 rebounds.
And at center, a 5'10" sophomore, number 30, Sandy Grabowski.
Sandy did not score, but still a very important part of that win this afternoon.
The coach of the Crown Point Bulldogs, Tom May.
Tom May, third year, now 59-9, almost 90% of his victories. Well, we'll be back with the opening tip-off in just a half a minute. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. At Market Square Arena, along with Cinda Brown and Hilliard Gates. Cinda, your thoughts on tonight's championship game?
Well, I think it's going to be a real exciting match. Every time we have a championship game, it's an exciting game. And I would really hate to have to say who's going to win the ball game tonight. I think it's going to be a matter of who plays good defense, who gets the breaks, which way the ball bounces.
I think Big D is the item here tonight. Two outstanding teams, two officials. We have Mike Crouch on the left, and he is from Jonesboro. Henry Bills, Bruce Mayfield, the other official.
Well, we're set to play basketball now. Crown Point goes to 22-4 on the year, a win over Heritage, 57-49. Bedford 25-1 after a win over Indianapolis Thomas Carlisle High School, 47-46 today. Tap is in the air, controlled by Bedford North Lawrence. They'll be the visiting team again tonight as they were this afternoon against Howe. Right away, they go inside in a hurry and get the first 2 points of the game, and that is Sherry Farrell getting her first 2 points. Sherry had 9 points on 3 out of 6 shooting from the floor, 3 out of 3 from the free throw line. A steal by Tina Boren. Now to the point. Got inside again. We'll see here, Cinder Brown, if anything has changed dramatically from a setup standpoint offensively for Bedford North Lawrence. And the first question what guys like us always talk about is fatigue. That second game was not over until about, what, 2:30? Is that a factor at all?
I think so. I think that, well, history proves this to be true, that only one team has won the second game and then won the championship.
Rebounded by Crown Point. Second time they've touched the basketball. For the first time, they get it into the front court with a chance to set up their offense. 2-0 basketball game. Bedford North Lawrence is out in front.
Man-to-man defense by Crown Point.
And Bedford North Lawrence, too.
And Bedford North Lawrence, too, as a matter of fact. You'll hear it.
Right.
Crown Point and Kovachkov and Nancy Cowan are the guards. Tammy Hammel and Merritt Erickson are the forwards. Ball is snapped away. Sandy Grabowski is the center. As I said earlier, she did not score, but she still played a very important role in this afternoon's game. Here's the first foul of the game. It'll go against Tina Boruff, number one on her. And, of course, the first foul would not involve any shooting. So the Lady Bulldogs of Crown Point will inbound. And there's a look across the way at Bedford North Lawrence head coach Pete Pritchett, 48 years of age, married. He and his wife, Marilyn Sue, the father of a couple of youngsters, Aaron Austin, 15, and Kristen Sue, who's 12 years of age. Right now, he's more concerned about one thing, his ball club playing defense. They got that rebound from Kelly Fitzgerald. Boy, this young lady had a sensational afternoon. Oh, great lead pass, and they got the shot. That is Sherry Farrell's second bucket. That pass by Kelly Fitzgerald, Sender, was right on the money.
Super bounce pass, led her just perfect.
4-0 basketball game. Bedford North Lawrence is out in front, trying to take a state championship trophy south of the midcourt line as far as the state of Indiana is concerned. And Kovachkov, she's at guard with Nancy Cowan. Gets it inside. Tammy Hamill, that's a strong effort this afternoon, getting her first 2 points of the game. The basket will count. Now the foul is called against number 23 of Bedford North Lawrence. That is Sherry Farrell, number one on her.
Tammy makes a great baseline drive, puts the ball up, draws the foul from Sherry, and 2 points. Got a chance for a three-point play.
Excellent baseline shooter, isn't she?
Super.
Tammy Hammel had an awfully strong performance in that win over Heritage. She was 9 of 14 from the field and 5 out of 7 from the free throw line. And she's perfect so far tonight. That cuts that 4-0 lead to 4-3 in a hurry. Couple of minutes gone. First quarter of play for the state championship. Well, same thing as this afternoon, Cinda. They backed off on Tina Boruff, and if they do that, I'll guarantee you, based on what we saw today, she's going to take that 18-footer.
Looks like she's warmed up a lot faster tonight than she did this afternoon.
Took her a while to get on track. When she finally did, she started popping a bit from about that same distance. Turnover again. Bedford North Lawrence with it. They've got a 6-3 lead. Give her room again. This one won't go, though. It's off to the right side. The rebound comes down into the hands of Sandy Grabowski. Penetration by Nancy Cowan, and there is a foul as she goes to the hoop. And that may be on Boruff again. No, it is not. Instead, it's on 43.
Nancy had a great change of pace move here. She sort of started like she was going to slow down, and then she really drove and drew the foul.
Loud is on Kelly Fitzgerald, number one on her, third against the ball club. Lady Bulldogs having some trouble getting it in, but finally do. Tammy Hammel on the baseline. Shot comes up short. The rebound is pulled off by Bobbi Jo Lovell. Foul, I believe, prior to the shot on Crown Point. And Bulldogs on number 40. That'll be Merritt Erickson. That's the first on her and the first against Crown Point.
Sherry received that outlet pass, and she just drove right down the middle of the floor and put the shot up. I think maybe Bedford's playing more their kind of game tonight than what we saw this afternoon.
This is a different offensive attack, at least at this point of the game, I think. Cindy, you're right. They're going right at the opposition, in this case, Crown Point. Bedford-North Lawrence had a struggle against that Howe ball club. And they've worked it inside again, and Bobbi Jo Lovell has her first 2 points of the game. She had only three in that win over Howe this afternoon, so she's two-thirds of the way home there already. And it's an 8-3 basketball game. Bedford-North Lawrence on in front by five, the biggest margin. Over the top of the board off the missed shot by Merritt Erickson.
That's and a shot she was hitting this afternoon, exactly. 7 out of 9.
I get the feeling while Bedford-North Lawrence has got their game plan pretty well under tow already, that Crown Point's still kind of stretching to put things together, Hilliard.
I think that's a very good observation. They're not into their normal offense yet.
Bedford-North Lawrence wearing the red uniforms. They are the guest team on the scoreboard, although it'll say they're BNL, Bedford-North Lawrence. Ball kicked away, now change of the lineup. Crown Point will insert into the lineup for the first time Penny Thomas. She played this afternoon, did not score. And out will go Sandy Grabowski, the 5'10 sophomore. Played 3.5 minutes in the change and the pivot. Any thoughts on that?
I think that Sandy doesn't have her glasses on. Now, I don't know if she wears contacts. She had glasses on this afternoon. I don't know if that makes a difference.
Good observation. I didn't see it either. His shot, rebound, Crown Point. They go inside, and it's off the fingertips of Penny Thomas, who just came into that lineup. Led her just a little too far. We've got another change in the lineup. And Missy Spinks now for Crown Point, number 32, who played this afternoon, scored 3 points. In that win over Heritage, will come in replacing Merritt Erickson. Merritt going out with no points, and one personal foul.
Crown Point's in their full court man-to-man, sort of a token man-to-man. They don't try to double team or steal the ball. There's putting pressure up, bringing the ball down the floor.
Bedford-North Lawrence moves the ball very well. Fitzgerald drops it inside. The missed shot and the rebound comes out of here to Crown Point's Tammy Hammel. This is Nancy Cowan. 20-minute guard is Ann Gavotkoff. And going one-on-one, going around team the board, missing the shot, foul call. And it's against Bedford-North Lawrence.
Sherry Farrell.
I put it on Tina Boruff.
Second,
beg your pardon, it is on Farrell. They signify 21, then change it to 23. Hilliard, so it is on Sherry Farrell. That's the fourth against the ball club, but she was in the act of shooting, so Ann Kovatskov goes to the line. She was 2 out of 3 from the fire this afternoon. Pretty good free throw shooter, 62%. Cowan, her running mate at guard, is topped in the ball club at 72%.
And has a colorful personality. She's only a sophomore.
Jump shot free throw. Rebounded by Nancy Cowan. Back to Gavotchkov. Back to Cowan again. Gets the 20-footer away. And rebound goes out of bounds, too, up for North Boyce.
Nancy Cowan has not gotten into the tournament yet. She's an 18-point-per-game shooter. Her shots tonight have been a little short, and it's interesting to see whether she's going to get on track.
She had only 6 points this afternoon, Hilliard, but she handed out 7 assists, and that led Crown Point in that department. Here's Fitzgerald. Had to force the shot. The rebound is on the floor. He'll jump it up. Bedford-North Lawrence is also almost, Cindy, it looks like, approaching their offense with reckless abandon.
Just the opposite of what they played this afternoon. Maybe they're just finally warming up to the Market Square Arena atmosphere, but it's definitely a different kind of team than we've seen from this afternoon.
Oh, yeah, very much so.
A lot more exciting to watch.
Yeah, absolutely, I can assure you of that. 3:20 to play, first period. It's 8-4 now. Bedford-North Lawrence with the lead. They have not been behind. Their biggest lead has been 5 at 8-3. Fitzgerald finally does get it out of the corner of the free throw stripe, and back at it goes to Boruff again. Now they've slowed down the offense just a bit. Nice shirt underneath. The rebound comes down to Ann Kovatskoy. Ann will bring it across the timeline. Penetration, 10-footer baseline, yes. Good ball herself that time. Got the rebound at one end and the field goal to the other. That's only the second field goal for Crown Point. And the third point for Ann Kovatskoy. She's halfway to her total of the first game of the day in that victory over Heritage. Fitzgerald. Kelly Fitzgerald had 9 points today, but the points are with the exception of the free throws she made at the end of the game, are not significant because, well, they are significant, but she played so very well defensively and offensively. Giving up the ball was just amazing. That is Hammel. Tammy Hamill's second bucket. She has 5 points. And it's now a 10-8 ball game. So that 5-point lead just dwindled to 2. And Fitzgerald, getting some pressure, brings it across the line. She had 2 defensive players on her. Somebody was open, but she couldn't find it. This is Sargent. Luann Sargent, who started at one of the forward spots. Now it comes near side to Tina Boruff. Only a shooting room for Bobbi Jo Lovell. She chose not to. Out of Fitzgerald. Now they slow things down again, Cindy. This is more like the offensive
trying to get things set up. Good drive by Kelly.
Fitzgerald, second bucket, 4 points. She shot very well this afternoon. Shot 4 out of 7, so she didn't take all that many shots. And was 1 for 3 from the free throw line. But that one shot came with 14 seconds to go. Gave them the 1-point margin that stood up with a 47-46 win over Howe. 1.5 minutes to go, first quarter.
You know, we're seeing that Bedford's playing a different game. We might hand a little bit of that to Howe's 1-3-1 defense. That's a different kind of defense to play these two.
And the size inside they faced against Howe, they're not facing necessarily tonight.
Tammy gets the shot, tries to drive inside. She got good position, and Sherrod just bumped her with the body.
That is Farrell's third personal foul, according to my sheet, and they show it on the board as only number 2. So here I'm thinking that maybe that foul earlier on Boruff that I called should have gone to Boruff.
Right.
They announced 23 and then showed 21. So with 1:22 to play here in the first period, there was a delay in the action here. We thought there was a timeout coming up. Apparently not. Yeah, they show it as number 2 on Farrell, so let's have to go, I assume, Hillier, with the fact that Tina Boruff may have picked up that other personal foul.
We'll watch the next one.
Tammy Hammel. She is 2 out of 2, and she has 6 of the 9 points that Crown Point has showing right now.
They were talking about a timeout, but they can't do it with a girl going to the foul line.
So Tammy will go again from the 15-foot charity stripe. And the rebound comes off to Bedford North Lawrence. They whip it out to Tina Boruff. Boruff will let the traffic set up. Get it down there on that right side to Bobbi Jo Lovell. She played most of the first game today in that same area down there and had some problems from time to time. Now there is a timeout. With 1:08 to go in the first quarter, the score is Bedford North Lawrence 12 and Crown Point 9. Back in a minute. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. I'm feeling some of the fatigue of a very long day, and I get the feeling that maybe these ball clubs are feeling that right now, Cindy.
I think so, too, and I don't see that one over the other. I think they both look a little tired.
Exactly. Well, Hillier, I think that Tom May told you that he was going to keep his ball club around and watch part of that second game, or most of that second game, for that matter. Here's a foul, and again, a good, strong effort to the hoop, and the foul is against Crown Point. It'll be on Nancy Cowan, who went down hard. She's up off the deck. That's her first foul.
Kelly's certainly taking the ball to the hoop a lot stronger than she did in the afternoon game. Really drives and puts the ball up. I think that left-hand shot sort of is hard for the people to stop when you're not used to it.
Coach Pritchett claims that Kelly Fitzgerald is the most unselfish player he has. She works hard, very consistent, and plays both ends of the court, and is also an excellent assist maker.
That is the first free throw attempt that Bedford North Lawrence has had in this ball game. They are 1 out of 1. Kelly was 1 for 3, as I mentioned this afternoon. And now she's 2 out of 2 tonight. Bedford North Lawrence is a 61% free throw shooting team. Stat-wise, Bedford North Lawrence wins in almost every category except rebounding. Hammel, yes. Hammel has 3 field goals and 2 free throws, so she has 8 of the 11 points showing, and it's a 14-11 basketball game right now with Bedford North Lawrence out in front. Again, the advantage on the break, the missed shot, and the rebound comes off to Crown Point. Good effort that time from Tammy Hammel. Bobbi Jo Lovell had a great opportunity that time with the drive. Good head fake by Nancy Cowan. Got the shot, won't get the points, and gets the foul instead. Well, number 2 on Nancy. Determined effort on her part turned into a personal foul, the 3rd against the club.
Nancy makes a good drive on the left side of the floor. Well, I'd say that Kelly had both feet planted. It's a good call.
So with the 13 foul against Crown Point, Bedford North Lawrence has committed 5, make it 4, and the advantage scoring-wise belongs to Bedford North Lawrence, 14-11. They've been ahead by 5. They have never trailed, and the game has never been tied.
Nancy's a very intent player. If you watch her when she's playing defense, it looks like she's talking to herself all the time. Get that ball, get that ball.
They made a substitution for Bedford North Lawrence, Amy Marone. 5'7 junior, number 11 is in the lineup. She averages almost five a game. She had two this afternoon. We're down to the final 9 seconds of the first period. Fitzgerald spinning and scoring. Great play. Fitzgerald with 8, 2 seconds, one. That's it, the end of the first quarter. And after one, it's Bedford North Lawrence 16, Crown Point 11. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. One of the attractive fans here on hand at Market Square Arena on a Saturday night, 1 month from tonight. We'll be back here again deciding the boys' state championship, Hilliard.
That's right, on March the 26th, and that should be a dandy.
Yeah, it will be a beauty.
You've got a lot of great teams here in Indianapolis.
We've got them all over the state this year. Somebody asked me before the game about who I would pick, and I said, I can give you about a dozen teams right now that could walk away with it.
There's two pretty good ones up in Michigan City.
There's a whole flock up here in town, but they beat each other up so bad that none of them may get out of here. First quarter is now 16-11. It's Bedford North Lawrence out in front, and they have totally outplayed Crown Point in that first period of the game. If Cinda's thoughts on that, as we have an opportunity here. Crown Point's going to have to get, I think, Cinda, a little more aggressive offensively, particularly. They just seem to be a little lackadaisical in the first quarter.
I think they might have to make an adjustment defensively, too. They're letting that open middle open in that man-to-man defense for Fitzgerald to drive. They might maybe try to zone him and make him take that outside shot.
That's Kovachkov running around. The big pick being set by Tammy Hammel. Now they bring it back outside again to Merritt Erickson, who's back in that lineup. Crown Point has made some substitutions, and they've gone back basically out of their starting lineup. Rebound comes right down into the hands of Bedford North Lawrence's Luann Sargent. Now the lead pass goes up court to Tina Boruff. Can't get it. Rebound picked off by Bobbi Jo Lovell, and a foul is called. And it may be on Lovell. No, it is not. It's against Bedford North Lawrence. It'll be on, well, yeah, no, they do signify Bobbi Jo Lovell. Yes, it is. And that is her first. And we are in the bonus, I believe. So we will take the foul shots.
I think it's a good call. Tina misses the layup, and Bobbi Jo goes up for the rebound. She goes up over the back of the Crown Point girls who had good position.
Well, with the ball in possession, though.
Questions. A little confusion here as Pete Pritchett looks on across the way. He was wondering what was going on, and it was simply a referee's question as, are we in the bonus as of yet? And that's precisely what was decided by the stat crew across the way, which is the same statistical crew that works the Indiana Pacers game. So to get a good idea what's going on, as many games as they get to see throughout the year. This is Misty Spinks at the free throw line for the first opportunity. She had one out of two this afternoon, came up with 3 points. She's a 71% free throw shooter. Missy now with two, and the lead is chopped down to three and 16-13. A steal right in front of us here. Nancy Cowan. Rebound right back down into the hands of Tina Boruff. Taken away again, though, by Cowan. Now it's out to Missy Spinks. Well, they set the offense up very wisely so.
Right, Nancy's really working hard. She missed that shot, went back for another steal. Now she can just get the shots to fall for.
Well, she's had a tough time so far in this game. Loose ball down into the hands of Bobbi Jo Lovell. Lead pass, too far. Kelly Fitzgerald. Yeah, the intended receiver down into the hoop, Luann Sargent, just threw it out of her reach. Luann coming back onto the floor here at Market Square Arena. 6 minutes, 40 seconds to play in the half. 16-13, we've got some excitement for you at halftime. We'll be showing you, of course, the Heritage Ball Club and Indianapolis Howe as they receive their medals. And then we'll be looking at some of the past award winners here at Market Square Arena. Boy, they get it inside. Off the mark, Tammy Hamill's shot. Bedford North Lawrence has got it again.
Can't buy a basket.
Well, Crown Point is having, they're not all that bad a shot. They just simply aren't falling for it. 5 minutes, 55 seconds to play, first half. They've come out now a little closer defensively on Tina Boruff.
Don't let her get shot.
Lovell.
shot by Bobbi Jo.
He just kind of rolled out of a little pick down along the baseline, came out to the free throw line area. They hit her with the pass. Nobody went to get her. They were covering up Boruff that time. 5.5 minutes to go in the half. An 18-13 lead again for Bedford North Lawrence. Back to that 5-point margin. They have not been behind. The game has not been tied. And Bedford North Lawrence, beaten only once this year, right now is playing much the better brand of basketball. And Crown Point having trouble just getting their offense set up and operating like they did in that victory over Heritage when they played so very well today. Knocked away again, but saved by Crown Point. Lady Bulldogs being double-teamed and trapped deep in that corner. They shut the baseline off brilliantly that time. Fine play by Bobbi Jo Lovell, and they take it away again.
Crown Point's really having trouble with Bedford's man-to-man defense.
Spinning into the lane, Fitzgerald. Nope, not this time. And the rebound down into the hands of Nancy Cowan. Leading scorer at 18-4. She has not scored yet tonight. We had 9 this afternoon. Near side, Erickson. Yes.
Like the shot she's taking this afternoon.
That's the same replay.
Exactly, and that's her first bucket of the game also. She hit 7 out of 9 earlier today. John, what's Merritt Erickson had so far in this game tonight? She's had 1 out of 2. Yeah, it's not all that bad. She hasn't had that many shots. That's the problem. John Hostel looking the longest again. Turn the ball over.
I think Tina made a real tactical error there. She had a 2-on-1 or maybe a 3-on-1 in the fast break, and she stopped and slowed it up. Of course, maybe that's what their game plan was.
18-15 score. Bedford North Lawrence with the lead. Crown Point has the basketball. Again, they trap in that corner over there right in front of the Bedford North Lawrence bench. They come outside again. The shot is short by Erickson. A whistle and a foul on the rebound. And it's against Bedford North Lawrence, Bobbi Jo Lovell. And I've got it for 2.
Merritt takes another shot from her favorite spot. Rebound, and they're just fighting for the rebound, and she did reach over Tammy's shoulder. And then Sherry had the nicest smile on her face after they called the foul.
Crown Point is not snapping their passes off, and that means they're not moving quickly either. I think they've got to increase the tempo of their play.
1-1 for Tammy. Rebound off to Bedford North Lawrence. Crown Point is 2 out of 3 from the free throw line this period. Fitzgerald gets it up in a hurry, then brings it back outside. That'll give Boruff room again. It's only her second bucket, but they have both come from about 16 to 18 feet. She steals the inbound pass. Open on the far side for the 10th minute. It's good. It's Kimberly Carey who came in during the last dead ball. And Kimberly, who had no points this afternoon, gets her first 2, and it's a 7-point lead. Timeout has been called. 3:44 to play in the half. 22-15 Bedford North Lawrence. Back in a minute. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Strangely enough, both leading scorers for the clubs. Crown Point being led by Tammy Hammel with 8 and Kelly Fitzgerald with 8. But both scored all their points in the first quarter. They have not done any scoring here in the second period, which is over halfway through. 3:42 to play, as a matter of fact, in the first half. Crown Point basketball, and the observation was made by Senator during the timeout. They just haven't got into their offense. Probably the pleasure to find defense being employed by Bedford North Lawrence, and there's an example of it. No advantage on the break. Fitzgerald drops it off on the far side and gets the return pass. Out to Boruff again. Not this time. Plenty of white shirts inside. And the rebound comes out to Ann Kabachkov.
Crown Point's done a great job on the defensive boards. Most of the time when Bedford North Lawrence is taking the outside shot, they're only getting 1 shot.
Cowan, yes.
There she goes.
Finally, Nancy makes the Nets ripple. She gets her first 2 of the game. She had 9 this afternoon, an average of 18-4. 5'5 junior starting guard. It's 3 out of 8 from the floor, and that's her first 1 of the night, though. It cuts the lead to 22-17. 7-point lead, by the way. Signify the largest lead that either ball club had had. Indeed, Crown Point has not been ahead in this ball game. Walking violation. They ran again. Bobbi Jo Lovell off of the free throw stripe, and she shuffled her feet. Now a substitution for Crown Point number 30, Sandy Grabowski, coming back into the ball game, and she will replace number 40, Merritt Erickson. So Merritt, one of the starting forwards, goes out, and Sandy Grabowski, who began the ball game in the pivot, comes back into the lineup.
Bedford's 2-2-1 press is sort of token until they get to the 10-second line, just like they did this afternoon when they're trying to trap and then dropping back into a man-to-man defense, and that's really tough to do.
Kibachkov to Cowan, and down deep in that corner, and back out it comes down to Missy Spinks. Here's Cowan again. And inside to Hamill. Oh, that's a fine play. I think, Jody, you mentioned earlier, she likes that baseline area real well.
She does. And we mentioned she's playing with a stress fracture on the left leg.
We didn't mention it tonight, but it's a point well made. And Kovachkov commits the personal foul.
Amazing thing that she's on crutches except when she's playing the ball game.
You know what I got from her coach? They call it 3 multiple stress fractures in her left leg.
Maybe.
You and I would be in a sling for months, Hilliard.
I'd cry
all the time, beg for some kind of mercy. And she doesn't even show any signs of limping when she's playing. She just, we're talking about number 35 in white, Tammy Hammel. Turnover again. Now, Bedford-North Boruff, last 2 or 3 times up, shown some signs of lack of intensity, perhaps. They've turned the ball over a couple of times. They have taken number 21, Tina Boruff, out of the lineup. She has 4 points, a field goal in each quarter. And they now have Amy Moran in that lineup at one of the guard spots, along with Kelly Fitzgerald. It's a 22-19 ball game. That 7-point lead has been cut down to 3 with 1:49 to go in the half. Back up once. How about twice? Nope, nothing going there. It was in the hands of Sandy Grabowski, and Kelly Fitzgerald sneaked in and put her hands on it also. Turnovers. Bedford-North Boruff had none in the first quarter, but they have turned it over 6 times in the second quarter of play. There is Tom May, head coach of the Crown Point Lady Bulldogs, 34 years of age, married. He and his wife, Nancy, the parents of Jennifer and Jeffrey. Jennifer's 9 and Jeffrey is 6, and I guarantee you they're here tonight. Position on the rebound by Tammy Hammel again. Hammel now with a dozen points. She is head and shoulders with everybody else in that scoring lineup. They cut that 7-point lead to 1 now at 22-21. So the offense is beginning to take some shape out there now, Sinden.
Tammy's been in great offensive position for that offensive rebound.
That's 6 unanswered points. Now here's the foul. It's on Hammel. Number 1 on Tammy.
Got a pass in to Bobbi Jo, and Tammy tries to block it from the back. She blocked the ball fine, but she got her on the back with her body.
As we come back live at Market Square Arena, Bobbi Jo Lovell, the 5'10 senior, at the free throw stripe for the first time. 57% shooter, 1 out of 2 this afternoon. With 5 points in the contest, kicks the lead back up to 2 again at 23-21. Bobbi Jo Lovell averaged 10 points per game last year. Another free throw. She averaged just a shade over 9 this season. Half a dozen points in tonight's game. She had 3 this afternoon, so she's doubled her scoring average already. Her scoring total, anyway. Down to exactly a minute to play here in the first half. A lot of activity coming up at halftime. Stick around. Off the mark, Nancy Cowan. Rebounded by Kelly Fitzgerald. 3-on-1 on the break. She turned it over. One person back on the break, and that particular person, didn't catch who it was, but she positioned herself so beautifully that Fitzgerald ran herself into a 3-on-1 break and ran herself right out of that break, as a matter of fact.
I think she would have made the pass 1 dribble sooner. She'd have been all right.
Been in good shape at that point in time. This is Debbie Hamilton, 5'6", junior, who did not play this afternoon, number 24 for Crown Point, in the lineup for the first time today. Scoots along that baseline. Outside is Tammy Hammel again. And the rebound pulled off by Crown Point. Put back up and nothing shaken this time. And the rebound to Kimberly Carey. Bedford-North Boruff, after a tough, hard-fought, come-from-behind win over Indianapolis High, 47-46, has really played well in the first half. They've got a 3-point lead, 24-21, with 20 seconds to play. Moran Sargent looking up at the big scoreboard and clock here at Market Square Arena, which shows now 10 seconds to play in the half. Sargent with the basketball. And they want to go to Fitzgerald. It's down to 6. Now it says 5. Sargent takes the shot and hits him. Luann Sargent's first 2 points of the game. And at halftime, it is Bedford-North Boruff with a lead of 5 at 26-21 over Crown Point. Halftime is here, and a lot of things are going to happen. We'll be back in just a minute. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. We have hit the midway point of the state championship game in girls' high school basketball in the state of Indiana. The score at halftime is Bedford-North Boruff 26, Crown Point 21. Once again, back across the floor of Market Square Arena to our PA announcer, Scott Gray.
Ladies and gentlemen, we direct your attention to the south side of the arena for the presentation of finalist medals to the two teams who participated this afternoon in our first session. Presenting the finalist medals to Heritage High School will be Doyle Lehman, assisted by Doug Adams, both members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. First, Carla Fry. Jody Bierman. Jenny Owen. Diana Schultz. Gretchen Albersmeyer. Rhonda Maldini. Julie Grotrian. Terry Lighty.
On behalf of the ACAC,
Lori Kahn. Jenny McCullum. Shelley Newark. Linda Furman. Student manager Amanda McCullum.
Coach.
Head coach Sherry Gilbert. Assistant coach David Gilbert.
There you are, guys.
Athletic director Larry Robbins.
Congratulations, Larry.
And principal Claron Hannafell.
Congratulations.
Two more points, though.
Need two more points? We're proud of you guys.
And now presenting the finalist medals to Indianapolis Howe High School will be Jim Fulford, assisted by Ed Raber, members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. First, Teresa Jones. Sharon Duke. Sharon Taps. Tammy Bell. Paula Slaughter. Sandy Hawkins. Natalie Oakes. Shante Sanders. Tracy Price. Linda Ward. Shaveen Bridgeford. Student manager Lisa Cosby. Student manager Carol Perry. Assistant coach Julie Herdman. Head coach Otis Curry. Athletic director Rick Hewitt. And principal Frank Taut. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for our finalists for 1983.
The teams of Heritage and Indianapolis South. Halftime score 26-21. Bedford-North Lawrence leads Crown Point. Let's pause now for these messages.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Indiana High School Athletic Association Mental Attitude Award is presented each year in each of the 18 IHSAA state tournaments. This to an outstanding senior who has been nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school, and also participated as a state finalist in the sport and was selected by the IHSAA Executive Committee. the IHSAA is extremely proud to welcome 28 of the 66 recipients of this coveted award from the 8 girls sports. To greet them tonight are Commissioner Ward Brown and the 1982-83 Indiana High School Athletic Association Executive Committee, Douglas Adams of Michigan City Rogers High School, Amzie Miller, New Prairie High School, Doyle Lehman, Adams Central School Corporation, Robert Strait, Huntington North High School, James Fulford, Owen Valley High School, Don White, Covington High School, Ray Kraft, Shelbyville High School, Orvis Birdsdale, Alexandria High School, Edward Raber, Tecumseh High School, and Don Noblet, Jasper High School. In order that we may properly recognize our distinguished guest, please hold your applause until we have presented all 28 recipients. First, from girls golf, from 1973-74, Susan Kirby, Greenfield Central High School, currently a sales representative for Park Davis Pharmaceutical Company in Louisville, Kentucky. From 1977-78, Julia Hudson, North Central, Indianapolis, a student at Purdue University. From 1978-79, Janice Kleiman, Rushville High School, a student at Indiana University. From 1982-83, Elizabeth Akers, Springs Valley High School, a senior at Springs Valley High School. In girls cross country, from 1982-83, Carol McIntyre, Carmel High School, a senior at Carmel High School. In girls volleyball, from 1972-73, Marianne Lise Wantuck of South Bend St. Joseph's High School, currently an executive secretary in South Bend. From 1973-74, Brenda Andis Tilley, Greencastle High School, computer programmer in Indianapolis. 1980-81, Becky Winsett, Boonville High School, a student at Purdue University. And 1982-83, Jill Ackerman from Jasper High School, a senior at Jasper High School. In girls swimming, 1974-75, Pat Lavin Barnes from North Central High School, Indianapolis, currently a teacher in the Carmel School System. 1975-76, Carol Bartholomew Stoner, Valparaiso High School, oncology nurse specialist in Valparaiso. 1976-77, Deborah McFadden Andrews, Kokomo Hayworth High School, an assistant librarian in Kokomo. From 1977-78, Mara Hagen Hain, Terre Haute South High School, a graduate student, assistant swimming coach at Indiana State University. And from 1982-83, Laura Ashburn, Ben Davis High School in Indianapolis, a senior at Ben Davis. In girls basketball, from 1975-76, Judy Warren, Warsaw High School, a teacher and coach at Maconaqua High School in Bunker Hill. From 1976-77, Terry Rosinski, Norwell High School, a senior at Indiana University. From 1977-78, Carol Blauvel, Heritage High School, a teacher and coach at Fort Wayne Glinger High School. From 1979-80, Amy Matheny, Southport High School, a student at Indiana University. From 1980-81, Susan Morris, Chesterton High School, a student at Butler University. And from 1981-82, Cindy Willis from Valparaiso High School, a student at Indiana University. In girls gymnastics, from 1977-78, Karen Kemper from North Central High School in Indianapolis, a teacher and coach in Wayne Township. In girls tennis, from 1975 and 76, Ann Bauer, Muncie Northside, telecommunications analyst, Indiana National Bank in Indianapolis. From 1977-78, Carrie Mulland of Munster High School, an account executive, American Bell, Indianapolis. from 1978-79, Marianne Guinea from LaPorte High School, a student at Indiana University. And from 1980-81, Brenda Fussey from Elkhart Central High School, a student at Valparaiso University. In girls track and field from 1974 and 75, Debbie Quarles, Indianapolis, Washington High School, currently a data analyst in Indianapolis. 1975-76, Karen Wexler, Huntington North High School, part-time teacher, full-time training in track and field in Long Beach, California. And in 1981-82, Beth Happel, Indianapolis Cathedral High School, a student at Ohio State University. Ladies and gentlemen, these young women represent the excellence achieved through women's athletics in the state of Indiana. To them and all their counterparts who are unable to attend today, we say a collective thank you for representing yourself, your school, your community, and your state in a first-class way as Medal Attitude Award recipients. Congratulations, ladies.
Well, there is an all-star team of all-star teams in every sport in girls' high school athletics. Our congratulations to these fine young ladies. We'll return to Market Square Arena with a halftime scores. Bedford North Lawrence 26, Crown Point 21 in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Hello, this is Hilliard Gates. Oh, I'm sorry. Well, I have no idea what that F-I-G-I, I don't even want to know what that's supposed to stand for. Hello, this is Jerry Baker, Senator Brown, Hilliard Gates alongside. And we are back at Market Square Arena where the halftime score is 26-21. And just before we go to the stats, Senator, first half, some surprises. The Crown Point surprised you in one respect and Bedford in another respect.
Definitely. I'm real impressed with Bedford North Lawrence, the kind of game that they played in the first half. I think that we're seeing the real Bedford North Lawrence that we probably didn't see this afternoon. Real impressed with Kelly Fitzgerald. I think she's really doing a fine job. And I think that Crown Point maybe is going to come back and play a better job in the second half.
All right, we just have a couple of seconds here. The leading scores will show you just briefly here for Crown Point, I believe it is up first.
Tammy Hammel has 12 points, and she is hit on 5 out of 9 field goal attempts. Leading scorer for Bedford North Lawrence is Kelly Fitzgerald with 8. They drop down to Bobbi Jo Lovell with 6. They have balanced scoring again.
All right, halftime again. 26-21, Bedford North Lawrence. Back for the second half tip-off in a minute. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance.
Well, we're ready for the second half. You see halftime stats, free throws, 5 out of 8 for Crown Point, 4 of 4, 1,000% for Bedford North Lawrence, 63% against 100%, and field goals, 8 of 28 for Crown Point, 11 of 22 for Bedford North Lawrence.
Identical rebounds there, that surprises me just a bit, 17 all in the turnovers, not much advantage for either club there. Bedford North Lawrence turned it over 7 times, Crown Point 6 times. Interesting story, at the start of the season out in Bedford, they sold season tickets for 9 games for 50 cents apiece, $4.50. You know how many they sold?
No.
20. Now, we kicked the price up to $7 for the state finals. How many they sell?
3,000.
2,500. Such a deal I've got for you. I bet they sell some tickets next year down there, by golly. All right, we're set to go now. Bedford North Lawrence has got a 5-point lead. They had it as high as 7 in that second period. And the Crown Point Lady Bulldogs control the tip here in the second half. We'll see what changes may or may not have transpired. They get the baseline shot right off the bat.
They went to the wrong basket.
Oh, my gosh, they did go to the wrong way. And the referee hasn't realized it yet. Who made the hoop?
Kabachkov made it.
And Kabachkov has just scored in the wrong basket.
It's an over and back now.
Oh, my. If we get a chance to show that to you again, I hope we can. The problem is one of the officials says it's an over and back violation, and I'm not sure.
Well, I don't even know whether they lined up right.
Look, they were wrong at the tip.
I'm not sure if they were. It's a good point, Hilliard. I'm not sure they set them up right at the. Here we go.
They're right.
Okay.
Ann gets the ball and thinks that she's in her backcourt instead of
Okay, she did go the wrong way. It is an over and back violation. It was an accurate call.
Right.
Boy, that's a toughie. I'll tell you, that may be in the rule book, but they don't lay it out like that. You know, it's an obvious violation when you stop and go back and look at it, but the officials, God bless them, Mike Crouch and Bruce Mayfield, picked that thing up beautifully.
Thank goodness for the replay.
Wow.
Was it Director Blair? Was it
exactly.
Blair?
And in that case, it is to be corrected. Holy mackerel. What a way to start the second half. Neil, you were the first to recognize you'd gone to the rope. I missed that totally.
She hesitated for a moment, then she got turned around.
Well, Crown Point gets a couple of shots, come up empty. Now a steal. Here is the layup, and it's still won't go for Anja Botchkov.
Yeah, but that was the right basket.
She has had a terrible time in the first minute of this second half. She makes one at the wrong end. They negate that. Then she misses the layup. So we're down to a minute gone now in this third period. And at the other end, finally, it is Tina Boruff getting her sixth point of the game. Very much like this afternoon, Tina has not scored a lot of points. She had 16 today, but finally did score a lot of points. But she's played very well. And this is Kelly Fitzgerald. Well, she had a great ball game. She had 8 points to lead all the scorers for Bedford North Lawrence in the first half of play. We played a minute and a half. We've had a tremendous amount of excitement and 2 points. Kelly Fitzgerald again.
If you met Kelly Fitzgerald and didn't know around the street, you would know that her name would be Kelly Fitzgerald.
She looks like a Kelly Fitzgerald,
right,
doesn't she?
Exactly.
And boy, she has played well tonight. That takes the lead to 9 points. Now it goes back to 7 as Tammy Hammel gets her 14th point of the game. It's almost become a shootout now between Fitzgerald with 10 and Hamill with 14. And Bedford North Lawrence still has the lead at 30-23. They were up by 5 at halftime. They ran it to 9. Now it stands at 7. And Boruff. She is a 53% field goal shooter, and I guarantee you she must have, if she shot like that all year, she's had to take half those shots from outside the free throw line.
Well, very nice shot. Has good extension, although she doesn't jump too high with it, but she follows through well.
As we made this comment this afternoon, Cinder, they got more set shot shooters on that Bedford club than I've ever seen a ball club have.
Yeah, most of the time you gotta get a hand in the face so they can get the shot off and mess with the shot off.
Bedford North Lawrence has outscored Crown Point 10-2, and there doesn't seem to be at this juncture of the game anyway much that Crown Point can do about it. Bedford North Lawrence is playing a very good basketball game.
We stress that the first 3 minutes of the third quarter are very important as far as momentum and getting things to go your way, and Bedford North Lawrence is doing a good job of that.
You've read Bobby Knight's book.
Huh? Out of bounds to Crown Point. Here's a substitution now for the Lady Bulldogs coming into the lineup. 24, Debbie Hamilton played briefly in the first half. Out will go and Kavachkov, and has not scored since the first period, which she had a field goal and a free throw. 32-23, back to the 9-point lead. Crown Point is out in front, or Bedford North Lawrence is out in front, and Crown Point has the basketball. Hamill short, rebound. Nobody wants it. Finally, a jump ball is called. Climbing off the deck, Bobbi Jo Lovell, number 41 for Bedford North Lawrence.
Tammy's really hustling on those boards. She reaches, tries to tap it into Missy, and Missy ties the ball up the share.
So number 32, Missy Spinks, will step in and complete the other half of the jump ball situation, controlled by Kelly Fitzgerald. In a hurry, angles over to the far side, in front of her own coach and bench. Lou Ann Sargent in the middle. Whistle foul. Basket will not count. Foul is against number 40 for Crown Point, Merritt Erickson. And it's only her second and the first against Crown Point in the second half.
Kelly passes the ball in to Bobbi Jo, and Bobbi Jo had a good backdoor move, and Merritt got her on the back.
The team's first.
So the Stars will inbound beneath their own hoop. Indeed they do. Bobbi Jo Lovell. Back at the point. In the ball up the room, now they come to Fitzgerald. Rolls off on the far side, right down into the hands of Missy Spinks.
Zone defense by Crown Point on that sequence.
Those are outbounds into the basket. A lot of teams do that so they don't give them the easy bucket. Playing man-to-man.
5-point lead, and a superb rebound that time with the hands of Sherry Farrell. She was really out of position for the rebound, but managed to go in and somehow get it anyway. Fitzgerald over to Boruff. Now they swing it down to Luann Strait. Here's Sargent inside, missing the shot. The rebound right back to her again. Shuffles off and off the glass. And that is Sherry Farrell, and that's good ball movement there. Nine times out of ten, you would have expected Sargent to go back up with it, and she found the open man and hit her beautifully.
Biggest lead of the game.
Is 11 points, 34-23. Sia mentioned Bedford-North Lawrence has led since the outset of the contest by 5 in the first quarter, 7 in the second, now 11 in the third period. They have never been behind in this basketball game. Some shoving and pushing under the hoop, and the foul is against Debbie Hamilton of Crown Point, away from the ball.
Debbie is trying to get position underneath and just using her body a little bit to push away.
That is the second team foul against Crown Point here in this third period. Well, you got to wonder just a little bit what Tom May is going to do, Senator, to kind of stem the flow of this ball game, because it's just about to get away from him right now.
You definitely got to do something to change that momentum. And those kind of things don't make a change.
Well, Sherry Farrell, and all they're doing, it looks to me like, Senator, is maybe setting up on the baseline or setting a little pick down there, then rolling out to the free throw line. They get the pass, and they got the shot. They've made it look awfully easy, to be quite honest. There's a great baseline shot again by Tammy Hammel. It's going to count, and a personal foul called also. Hammel now with 16 points.
Tammy just has an unbelievable eye on the baseline. A good pass from Nancy, takes that baseline shot. She's not real close in this time. She's about 15 feet out, nothing but net.
All right, that foul was on Sherry Farrell of Bedford North Lawrence, and that is her third personal foul. Tammy Hammel, I just realized, I got a note from the coach that came in the mail today, as a matter of fact. Her father, Stu, is the boys' varsity basketball coach at North Newton High School, so it kind of runs in the family here. She misses the free throw and gets the rebound. And gets it on the other side.
Doesn't make any difference which side. She'll take that baseline jumper.
Well, she does love that baseline shot. That's 18 points now for Tammy. She had 23 this afternoon. She has an average of 14-1 coming into the contest. That cuts the lead down to 9 at 36-27 with 2:40 to play in the third period. And they come right back at the other end and get it on Bobbi Jo Lovell's shot, her 8th point of the game, first here in the second half. Fitzgerald, a bit of a token full-court press, actually a mid-court press, picked up with the timeline. And Kovachkov comes to the near side now. Sandy Grabowski is back in that lineup. Back to Hamill again. Here's Kovachkov. It's a big long step to turn the ball over. Nancy Cowan set to come back into the lineup, and a timeout is called. 2:14 to play, third period. Bedford North Lawrence 38, Crown Point 27. Timeout is called. We'll be back. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. With 2 minutes and 14 seconds to play in the third period, 38-27 is your score. Bedford North Lawrence out in front, and time is running out. And there's a sign up in the stands there, Hilliard.
Seymour wishes Ted Kitchell get well.
Oh, isn't that the truth? That young man for the Hoosiers of Bobby Knight with that back injury, and we wish him nothing but the best of recuperative powers. Well, that's something that Crown Point could use a little bit of right now, too. They've got themselves a real problem. Kelly Fitzgerald. I think Bedford North Lawrence now might be content to kind of drop this thing down a notch.
I think it'll run a little time off the clock here toward the end of the third quarter.
Now to 1:51 to play in this third period. Fitzgerald gets it inside beautifully. Great defensive play by Hamel, but apparently some contact also. The official right into the hoop spotted it. And she picks up personal foul number 2. Take a look at it again, Cindy.
Kelly makes a great bounce pass into Sherry. She puts the ball up. Well,
awful hard to see from here.
She might have got it from the body.
Almost had to.
It was on the fingertips if there was any contact.
Sherry Farrell will be at the free throw line. She was the leading scorer in the semi-state championship game with 15 points. She has 8 points so far in this contest. Bedford North Lawrence, last year 20-3, they lost to Sullivan in the Washington Regional. They have the top 8 players back this year. Rebounded by Bedford North Lawrence, but back up and good by Bobbi Jo Lovell. So they missed 2 free throws, and instead of Crown Point getting a chance to take advantage of that, they end up with a field goal. 1.5 minutes to go here in the third period. It's a 40-27 basketball game. Bedford North Lawrence out in front by 13, big ones. Position on the rebound and back up for the follow-up shot by Sandy Grabowski. And those are the first points that Sandy has scored all day long. She was shut out in the win over Heritage this afternoon and now gets her first 2 of the night's game. 1 minute, 5 seconds to play in this contest in a 40-29 affair with Bedford North Lawrence still out in front. Good ball movement. So they're really whipping that thing around the perimeter now.
Everybody coming to the ball from the weak side. It was a good pass by Kelly when Sherry's coming in low.
Sandy Grabowski picks up her first personal foul of the game. We're waiting now for the entry of Merritt Erickson into the game. Here she comes. We'll see who goes up. Yeah, replacing Missy Spinks.
Let's see if Crown Point stays in the 2-3 this time, or if they're playing man on the out of bounds.
Joe Pate, who's our executive producer of the program, indicates that since the score was 22-21, Bedford North Lawrence, Bedford has outscored Crown Point 18-8. Here's a foul on Crown Point, and Kavachko, number two on her. Nobody on Crown Point is in serious foul trouble, Hillier, but they're spreading them out all over the place.
That's right, and Tammy Hammel continues to do, what, 66% of the scoring?
Of the scoring, that is correct. Tina Boruff back at the free throw line off of Bedford North Lawrence Stars.
Nancy Cowan is back into the lineup for the Crown Point Bulldogs, and she's going to try to unpractice the ball club by herself. She's a great personal talent. She has not been able to score more than 2 points in this game tonight.
Tina Boruff had 22 against Evansville-Bossy in the first game of the semi-state. She had an awfully impressive performance of that game to help the Bedford North Lawrence Stars get to this point. Tina now has scored 6 points of this period, 4 in the first half, 10 of the night. She had 16 to lead the Stars this afternoon. They have gone in front now by 13 at 42-29 with 44 seconds to play in the third period. Crown Point basketball, they've got a lot of work to do. Almost a walk, it is a walk. Sandy Grabowski, she tried desperately to hold that pivot foot in position and just couldn't get it done. Another substitution, Missy Spinks coming in. I'm sure, Cindy, you've coached some games where you're sitting on the sideline, your ball club looks so good in the first game of the day or maybe previously that week, and they come out like this and there's not a thing in the world you can do about it.
You feel really hopeless. The kids are trying their hardest. They're trying to do everything, maybe trying a little bit too hard, and that's what makes them feel so bad.
Yeah, let's credit Bedford North Lawrence for perhaps causing that situation with Crown Point.
Absolutely right.
This is Boruff outside again. Swings it over to Sherry Farrell. Oh, they've moved the ball well, and they've changed the pace on their offense. They were really red hot at the first of the game. 12 seconds to go. The entire Bedford North Lawrence bench stood up almost on cue from Pete Pritchett, the coach. We're down to the final six, final five. Fitzgerald. Rebounded by Crown Point, threw it right back into the hands of one of the Bedford players, but that's the end of three. We have 8 more minutes of basketball to decide the state champion in girls basketball. 42-29, Bedford North Lawrence leads Crown Point. We'll be back after this. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance.
Bedford North Lawrence has limited the great backcourt combination of Nancy Cowan and Ann Kavachoff to only 5 points total in this game. Going into the contest, they've accounted for an average of about 33 points a game.
Bedford North Lawrence is 8 minutes away from their first ever state high school basketball championship. Crown Point will try to do something about that, but they've got a long way to go. It's 42-29, Bedford North Lawrence with a sizable lead, and they have built that lead throughout the game. They have never trailed, and the game has never been tied. Crown Point gets the ball to begin the fourth period of play. This is Kavachko off at the top of the free throw circle. Well, they just can't afford, Cindy, to waste much time working the offense, can they?
That's right, but they're definitely going at the right end this time.
That's true.
Great play by Kelly Fitzgerald there to break up that pass.
Fitzgerald's had a good ball game. She has scored well, but she's also been everywhere on this basketball floor at Market Square Arena tonight. Now, it's just the opposite of the other end. I'm sure they don't care how long it takes to set up the offensive patterns. This is Tina Boruff. She's played well also. Fitzgerald. Our floor camera looking right up the sideline on the north side of the floor. Shot is short, rebounded by Crown Point. Here they come again. They've got to at least get some shots away. Nancy Cowan. This is Hammel. And Erickson. And the rebound of Fitzgerald. Well, she just sneaks off one of those tall timbers under there. Fitzgerald takes it in, comes near side to Boruff. Got it. Gina with 12. She had 16 this afternoon. She is now the high scorer for Bedford North Lawrence. She has 12. Bobbi Jo Lovell and Kelly Fitzgerald each have 10. So they have 3 players in double figures. With 6 minutes and 38 seconds to go, it's 44-29. Walking violation, yes, on Nancy Cowan. I mentioned earlier, back at 22-21, Bedford North Lawrence in front by one. It is now 44-29, so Bedford North Lawrence has now outscored Crown Point 22-8.
It'll be interesting to see if Tina continues to take those 18-20-foot shots. She took one just a few minutes ago, and I was really surprised at that. Although there's a lot of time left, and you can't really try to hold the ball too much at this point.
I'm not so sure she won't. She seems to have so much confidence shot, Cinda. I just think she might take it if you're going to leave her alone out there. Nancy Ann Kovachkov picks up the personal foul. And that is the third on her. So it'll be 43, Kelly Fitzgerald going to the free throw line, Hilliard.
We've been talking so much about this young lady offensively. She's the one that has limited Nancy Cowan to one field goal. She's set up defensively on it.
Fitzgerald with 10, now 11. 3 out of 3 from the free throw stripe.
I love her intensity. She just goes at it 100%.
Well, she did, as they say, come to play tonight. You can see that from the opening tip. Now she goes into a tie with Tina Boruff for the scoring honors at 12 for the Bedford North Lawrence Stars. They were disappointed last year. They thought they had a chance to fight their way into the finals and didn't get here. There's a foul being called on Kelly Fitzgerald. That'll be the second on her. The basket will count. And a chance for a three-point play for the Crown Point Ball Club.
Merritt makes a great drive on the baseline on the left side of the floor, puts the ball up. I didn't really see the foul. They called it on Kelly. I guess it must have been as she was driving.
Erickson had 16 points in the victory over Heritage, and that is only her second field goal of tonight's game. Hilliard?
We've just been handed a note that there'll be a recognition program, win or lose, at Bedford North Lawrence. That'll be tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock. That's win or lose at Bedford North Lawrence.
Rebound picked off by Nancy Cowan. Cowan will go get it again, takes it away from Fitzgerald. In 11 minutes and a half, Kovachkov now even more. Bucket by Tammy Hammel. Crown Point scored 8 points in a little over 11 and a half minutes.
Crown Point's not going to sit back and quit.
Oh, there's a great play in front of us by Kelly Fitzgerald.
Tremendous.
Right in front of our broadcasting vantage point, the ball was going out of bounds, and watch what she does with it.
She hits it right on Merritt's knee. Merritt did try to get out of the way, but she couldn't do it.
Yeah, she
great
threw it
reflex.
With the left hand, too.
Well, of course, left-handed.
I hope so.
5 and a half minutes to play.
That answers that question.
Question, doesn't it? Tina Boruff with 14 now. The question why Cinder was, will she continue to take that outside shot? The answer is right there. Crown Point needs some points. They need them badly. In the middle, the red shirts continue to dominate play, and Crown Point goes back on defense. And across the way, the head coach of Crown Point, Tom May, looks on with his chin in his hand. There's just not much he can do about it right now. 48-33 basketball game, Bedford North Lawrence. Down to the final 4 minutes and 52 seconds of this contest.
It's a very frustrating feeling to sit on the bench and see your kids work so hard and know that sometimes just things aren't going to go your way.
Rebounded by Nancy Cowan. Now, particularly when they haven't given up by any stretch of the imagination, the kind of one I'm talking about, they have played extremely hard, and it just simply hasn't worked for them.
Tremendous.
Gary, at the outset, we talked about defense in this basketball game. It was going to be a factor early, and it's been a factor all the way.
It certainly has. With 4:36 to play in the game, 48-33. Bedford North Lawrence, timeout has been called. Let's pause for these messages. What do you see the most of in high school? Zone or?
We see mostly zone, but more man this year.
Pretty big mountain to climb. 15 points, 48-33 with 4:36 to play. But that ball club right there has not given up the ghost as of yet. Crown Point Lady Bulldogs break away from head coach Tom May. They come back out on the floor. It will be their ball under their own hoop. I thought there was a foul called.
There wasn't. I don't think they're in the 1-1 yet.
That's true. That's exactly what it is.
Only the third team foul.
There's a shot. Will it fall? It will. Finally does go for Ann Gavotskoy. That is her first field goal since the first quarter.
Ann really worked hard on her follow through on this shot. She drives inside, puts up the jumper, and then watch her. She just jumps. Well, you can't see her, but she jumps up and down, up and down, up and down, and finally it fell through.
Foul was on 41. Bobbi Jo Lovell, number three on her. And at that free throw line, you see is Ann Gavotskoy. That's the 3-point play. She now has a half a dozen points. Her average is 14-2. She only had six also in the game against Heritage, but she played very well. Here is a foul, called this time on Crown Point's Merritt Erickson, number three. And now things are really starting to kind of go sour. They're having all kinds of weird fouls.
Lots of time left in the ball game, too. 4 minutes and 29 seconds, 12 points. They can go real fast if Bedford tries to hold the ball too long. That was it. That foul hurt them right there since also, Bedford's in the 1-1.
Also, they must make these free throws to maintain that lead.
Definitely.
Substitution now for Crown Point. Coming back into the lineup, number 25, Gina Galambos. Actually, the first time we've seen Gina today. She is a 5'7 junior. She enters the lineup in place of Merritt Erickson, who goes out with 4 points.
That wasn't what you call exactly a zipper. We call zippers when they go through and don't touch anything but the rim. We got that from Del Ciciora from Valparaiso. That's what they called him, and we thought that was a real good term.
But you still
but it went
got
through.
It.
That's right.
Say, you still got it.
1 point.
What's that? A miss.
That's not too hard to figure that one out. Kelly Fitzgerald now with 13 points in the contest. 49-36. Bedford-North Orange out in front. They have been really tough in this game. Rebound, Bedford-North Orange. That's Tina Boruff, B-O-R-U-F-F. She's had a good ball game. Brings it across the timeline. Looking most of her shots. She's about 15, 16, 17 feet away. Now let's see if Bedford-North Orange might want to spread the floor a little bit, play keep away. Fitzgerald. And Kibotskoff into play D on her. 3 minutes and 50 seconds to play in this game. With all the time that's left in the point we are now in the decision of who will wear the crown, a girls' state high school basketball champions in Indiana.
I think Tina just got rid of the ball just in time that time. The referee had the count on her. If she hadn't made that pass, it might have been a 5-second call.
That was a great pass by Fitzgerald. Got it in the middle, and the shot would not go. We'll jump it up. Got the ball down low to Bobbi Jo Lovell. Lovell turned around and had not an uncontested shot, but a pretty good shot at it anyway. Timeout is being called with 3:28 to play here in the third period in a 49-36 basketball game. Bedford-North Orange is out in front. We'll pause for these messages. I wonder who that little guy's rooting for. You talk about an outfit.
I think it's a little gal, Jerry.
Oh, is it a gal? Now, wait a minute. Now, that's an assumption on your part, Cindy. Well, I take it back. Now that I've seen the rest.
I know a female cheerleader when I see
You know there's
that.
A critic in every crowd, Hilliard. Bedford-North Orange is growing them really young down there. I see, I couldn't see the skirt.
No.
Hilliard, what did you think?
Whatever you thought.
Jump ball. 3:25 to play. 13,000, almost 14,000 on hand tonight, and that is a record attendance for the finals of the Girls State High School Basketball Championship. 13,704. Isn't that super?
That's great. And I think it'll continue to grow every year.
And 12,750 or so this afternoon.
It has indeed grown every year. The total attendance, as a matter of fact, from sectionals right up through the championship game. But more important matters at hand, Crown Point. Can they come back? Miraculously so, down 13 with 3:15 to go. There's two of them right there. That's Nancy Cowan. Well, they just got to have some points out of Nancy and Ann at that guard spot. That's only the fourth point for Cowan in this ball game. And here is a foul. The total attendance, by the way, for this afternoon session and tonight comes to 26,433, and that is a record also.
Kelly drives the ball on the right or on the left side of the floor and reaches in. Cardinal sin when you're playing defense. You got to move with him. Move those feet.
That's four fouls on Ann Kabatra.
Okay, fourth one on her. Is it too early to start that fouling now, Cindy? How do you feel from a coaching standpoint?
Well, if they miss him like that, it looks like it's pretty good. But Ann's in trouble. She's going to have to be careful.
Kelly Fitzgerald missing the free throw. Out of bounds. Belongs to Crown Point. Right in front of Tom Mayer. The rest of the Crown Point Lady Bulldog bench over there. Sitting on the edge of their seats, hoping for something to happen here that'll get them back in this ballgame. Inside 3 minutes, they're down by 11. Now it's 9. Nancy Cowan, back-to-back field goals and outside. And the pressure being employed by the Lady Bulldogs, and their fans finally begin to get in the flow of things also across the way. To the right of your screen is where they are. Here's the 10-second violation. Tina Boruff just simply took too much time getting it across the timeline. And with 2:39 to go, down by 9, a field goal here. And we don't want to start closing the books on things just yet.
I did notice something during the timeout. The Crown Point cheering section was up cheering the whole time. Bedford-North Lawrence was sort of saying, like, we've got the game won. Now I don't think they're so secure.
How about Nancy Cowan for 3 in a row? She's got the hat trick, and it's a 49-42 basketball game. And I wouldn't be surprised to see Pete Pritchett call a timeout here and get his troops kind of reorganized again. He's got four timeouts left. But nope, they spread the floor now. This is Luann Sargent, swings to the right side, looking for help. Here is a foul. And the foul is against number 12, Nancy Cowan. That is the third on her. And Hilliard, the only players in serious trouble is Ann Kovachkov, so they can go ahead and commit those fouls and not have to worry about losing anybody. Timeout has been called by the Crown Point Club. They're down 49-42 with 2:05 to play. We'll take a timeout here. One of your network sponsors is American Fletcher National Bank. Along with Senator Brown and Hilliard Gates, Jerry Baker, courtside, Market Square Arena. Hilliard, this game has suddenly become a basketball game again.
Crown Point has outscored Bedford-North Lawrence 9-2 in this round.
Nancy Cowan's really caught fire.
That's been the key to it, as a matter of fact. She has had 3 successive field goals, both from the far side of the floor, both about 16 to 18 feet out, and that has really put Crown Point back within shooting distance again. They were down by 15 points in this period. At the free throw line, Bedford-North Lawrence, Luann Sargent. He has not been to the stripe yet tonight. These are important free throws right here.
That was a zipper.
That was a zipper. She's a 54% free throw shooter. She was 0 for 1 in this afternoon's win over Indianapolis Howe. 3 points down for Luann Sargent, who averages 7.2. Rebound picked off by Tammy Hammel. Boy, Hamill's had a good ball game. Very quickly they bring it across the timeline. 10th rebound for Tammy Hammel, according to John Oswald, who is keeping our team statistics here tonight. 1:51 to play for the championship. 50-42. Outside again. Yes! Nancy Cowan has strung 4 in a row together. And that 15-point lead is down to 6 with a minute and 39 seconds to play, and a jump ball is called. Superb defense by Nancy Cowan. Boy, I don't know what happened in the huddle over there, Hilliard, but something was said to ignite her.
Well, she was out of the game, remember, for about 2.5 minutes and came back, and she's been playing this way since she came back.
You had pointed out that she and Ann at guard had scored only 5 points through 3 periods tonight, and now all of a sudden she scored 8 points in the last couple of minutes. And the tip controlled by Crown Point. They move inside. They got 2 more. That is Tammy Hamill with 22. Now it is a 4-point game with a minute and 27 to go. There is a foul. Nancy Cowan commits it. I've got her for 4. Look at it one more time.
Nancy sneaks in from behind and tried to pick off the ball from behind Tina. Well, I couldn't really tell if she got her arm or if she got the ball.
Back live now at Market Square Arena with 1 minute and 22 seconds to play. A 4-point lead. What was a 15-point lead? Going maybe a minute into the fourth period. It's now down to 4, and the rebound comes off to Bedford-North Lawrence. Oh, an important rebound. Almost a superb defensive play by Tammy Hammel. If you look at that again, that's going to be another one of those really questionable or close calls. Take one more look at it here.
On the rebound, the free throw, Bobbi Jo gets it. There she is. Yeah, looked like Tammy got nothing but the ball, but the official didn't think so.
13-2. They've outscored them now.
Bobbi Jo Lovell at the free throw stripe now. Suddenly what was just a kind of a token appearance at the free throw line for the Bedford-North Lawrence players suddenly become very, very important. That's 11 now for Bobbi Jo Lovell. She had 3 in the win over Howell this afternoon. Her average is 9.1. Bedford-North Lawrence has only 2 field goals in the fourth period. They have really done well at the free throw stripe, hitting 6 out of 9. It's 52-46. Forcing your way in. Blocking foul called against Bedford-North Lawrence. Bobbi Jo Lovell now with 4. And And still plenty of time with a minute 12 to play in this contest.
Gina's on the weak side all by herself. Good pass by Ann. Gina's by herself, makes a good fake, and Bobbi Jo just didn't have a good position.
At the free throw line for Crown Point is number 25, Gina Galambos, a 5'7 junior, only a 14% shooter at that free throw stripe. She did not play, and this afternoon's win over Heritage. What a time to get a free throw from a 14% shooter.
That's hard.
Pressure will do it for you every time.
I guess so. That's all she needed was some pressure to shoot under. Gina Galambos, averaging less than a point a game. Got them both. Oh, there's a couple of big ones that young lady will remember. 1 minute and 10 seconds to play, 52 to 48. A loose ball and a jump ball. That was Kelly Fitzgerald, who could not get it across the timeline. And she will jump now with Gina Galambos. Gina's 5'7", Kelly is 5'3". So the Bulldogs have a chance to get this ball again. All she's got to do is give it over her head behind her. She couldn't get it done, but nonetheless, Crown Point comes out with the basketball. Nancy Cowan, boy, she has just been super. Inside, two more for Gina Galambos. She has 4 points.
I think that Bedford-North Lawrence needs a timeout.
I can't believe they haven't called the timeout, as a matter of fact. We'll jump it up again. Take the timeout now. Timeout has been called by Bedford-North Lawrence. A 15-point lead is down to 2 with 45 seconds to go. 52-50. Stick around. We'll be back in a minute. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. I'd have had those gals over there so quickly, boy. I'd have used them all if I'd have had to. He's got three left.
Yeah, I think he got involved in the game and just didn't think of it.
He just got out coached in the last couple of minutes here. Cinda and Hillier, they talk about the sixth man in basketball. There's one right there.
They've been great.
The Crown Point crowd, give them credit, because I'll tell you something. They've brought this ball club, at least partially so anyway, back into this ball game. And Nancy Cowan, who has the basketball, likewise, she's got a chance, or they have a chance. Kavotskov got it now to tie it. It won't go, and a foul is called. And now, Crown Point goes to the free throw line. And with a chance to tie the game, the foul is against number 21. That is Tina Boruff's third.
Ann couldn't decide what she's going to do. Then she goes ahead and drives down the middle and draws a foul. I tell you what, Crown Point, we were talking about how they were working so hard and not anything was going for them. Now, they've got that momentum going their way.
Suddenly, all that didn't happen in the first 2.5 quarters is now coming to in the final half of the fourth quarter. What a tremendous come-from-behind effort. Leapfrog shot man closer to get another. Fouled in the act of shooting. And Kavotkov is a 62% shooter. She was 2 out of 4 at the line to that shot there. She's missed 2 in a row.
35 seconds.
Missed them both, and the rebound taken off, and a foul called against Galambos. A Crown Point.
Might not be a bad foul, really. Stop the clock. Gonna have to walk down the floor, shoot the free throw. She really hated it, I'm sure, but it may not be a bad foul. No time off the clock.
So they're still pretty good shape time-wise, down by 2. I don't keep a running sheet time-wise here. I can't recall here when they were down by 15. But it could have been more than a minute or so gone in the fourth period. Timeout has been called with 34 seconds to play. It's 52-50. We'll be back in a minute. Let's pause now for these messages. 34 seconds remain to be played in this basketball game. It's now 52-50, your score. If you've walked away to go to the refrigerator, you're probably wondering what in the world is going on down here. I'll tell you what's going on. Nancy Cowan hit 4 straight field goals, and all of a sudden, all the nasty things that were happening to Crown Point have turned around and gone the other way.
It's an exciting game of basketball. You never know what's going to happen next.
Well, we're into the Crown Point huddle right now. Here's Bedford-North Lawrence coming back out. Gary?
I think Bedford-North Lawrence forgot what was going to happen for a second, but they're going to be shooting a free throw. They're getting ready to go back on defense.
Bedford North born stars come back on the floor first. Crown Point Lady Bulldogs right behind them. And at that free throw line for Bedford North Lawrence is Sherry Farrell.
And she's 0 for 2 tonight.
Indeed she is. She has 8 points. She has not scored this quarter. She's a 56% free throw shooter. And she was perfect 3 out of 3 earlier today. Well, there's a big one for Sherry. You know, this game was coasting along so easy if you were a Bedford North Lawrence fan, and suddenly it just went topsy-turvy. And Crown Point just played beautifully. Rebound by Crown Point, pulled down by Merritt Erickson. There's plenty of time. Now we're half a minute to go in this ball game. They've got to have a hoop here. Ann Kibotskoff, penetration inside. She can't get it. And the rebound comes off the Bedford North forehead. Kelly Fitzgerald, lead pass up court to Bobbi Jo Lovell. Lovell comes back outside. Let's see what's going to happen. 16, 15, 14. You watch it. There's the foul. It is against Tammy Hammel. That's 4 on her. It's also a get credit where credit is due to Bedford North Lawrence, because they could have almost folded up their tent when that run was made at them. Well, they did not.
Kept their composure even though the lead really dwindled down real fast. I don't think they really wanted to foul Tina, because she's such a good free throw shooter, but at this point you don't have any choice.
Right, you got to get the clock stopped.
Timeout has been called. We'll take a moment and thank the technical and production crews for tonight's telecast. Our executive producer is Michael Davis. Tonight's game was produced by Joe Pate and Jim Butler and directed by Peter Mago. Our unit manager was Bob DeLong. Dean McDowell was our network coordinator. Slow motion replay operator, Dick Blair. Good job, Dick. Video, Jim Miller, Mike Medert, Paul Horsewood. Audio by Bob DeLong and Lisa Haviland. Our cameras run by Kim Wesley, Susan Reese, Eddie Swanson, and Mike Pope. Jeff Durkendall is our floor director tonight. Statistician John Osler, Buck Way, our electronic graphics. Vicki Brayman, our production assistant. Say something about this gang here. They had a call, a crew call this morning at 5 o'clock. They showed up at the Channel 4 studios at WTTV here in town. They came right to Market Square Arena. They have been here all day long, and I salute them one and all. What a great job they did.
I echo those sentiments.
Into the huddle of Bedford North Lawrence.
5 seconds over outside.
Pete Pritchett now turns his ball club loose. Tom May has already gotten that job done. Tom May in his third year, Pete in his first year. These are young coaches in terms of service at these particular schools. Boy, they've grown some gray hair tonight, haven't they? The coaches do get that, don't you?
Mercy, I just cover mine up so nobody can see it.
At the free throw line, Tina Boruff. Under extreme pressure, Tina gets her 15th point. Bedford North Lawrence has only 2 field goals here in this fourth period. They've done most of the work at the free throw line. Rebounded by Hamill again. 54-40, it's a 54-50, 8 seconds to go. Here is Cowan missing, rebounded by Bedford North Lawrence, and a foul called on Nancy, and that should be 5 on her. And this young lady played a win in the fourth period. That is 10 points for Nancy Cowan as she fouls out of the ball game. And Pete Pritchett, head coach of Bedford North Lawrence, stands up and gives her a little round of applause also. There is Nancy. Nancy Cowan, 9 points this afternoon, 10 points tonight, and she hit 8 of the 10 in the fourth period when she hit 4 successive field goals. And we're going to get some changes across the way. Coming in, number 34, Beth Naldi, a 5'6 junior. Number 20, Peggy Small, a 5'6 senior. And number 50, Laura Platusic, a 5'11 junior.
Nice gesture on Coach Tom May's part. He's going to get every girl an opportunity to play in the state championship game, and I think that's great.
I do, too. Only 4 seconds remain, and it's a 4-point lead at 54-50. And it looks right now as though Bedford North Lawrence will stave off one of the best rallies probably ever in the girls' high school tournament and win this basketball game.
Well, and they will have won their 22nd consecutive ball game. They've lost only to Jeffersonville during the entire season.
Free throw shot is good by Bobbi Jo Lovell. Lovell now with 13 points. She had only 3 points in the win over Indianapolis High. Hilliard, if all goes well, you'll get a chance, I hope, to chat with perhaps the winning coach, time permitting.
It's going to be very close.
If not, we apologize for that. We have network commitments, of course, which have us getting in and out of our telecast on a certain schedule. 3 seconds. That's it. Going over. 45-50 is the score. Bedford North Lawrence, which looked for all the world as though they had everything totally wrapped up with the fourth period getting underway, suddenly find themselves battling for their existence, and they win it by five, 55-50. Hilliard Gaines has made his way out to courtside. Just enjoy some of the passion of the moment. We'll return to Market Square Arena after this commercial break. And now the bedlam continues on the floor here at Market Square Arena. This crowd of 13,704 is on hand, and Pete Pritchett will make his way down to the floor to chat with him just briefly. We have Brickley in scoring, 15 points for Tina Boruff, 13 for Kelly Fitzgerald, also 13 for Bobbi Jo Lovell. We're going out to Hilliard in just a moment as soon as our local station rejoins us here in town. 22-point total for Tammy Hammel in this ball game. The thrill of victory at Market Square Arena out to Hilliard Gates. Hilliard?
Speaking of the thrill of victory, here is Austin Pete Pritchett, the coach of the new girls state champions, Bedford-North Lawrence. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Hilliard. This is really an honor. Well, we're going to blow her there for a minute.
Well, they came at you. You didn't seem to change anything. They just came at you.
Yeah, they did. This number 12, I forget her name.
Nancy Cowan.
Now it's a Cowan. A terrific ball player. She about put us away.
What about your game plan here? What did you try to do tonight?
Well, we just tried to play our ball game. And I thought we had maybe possibly a little more quickness than they had. And I think that probably proved out during the third quarter is when we really won the ball game.
And you had a lot of balance again here tonight.
Yes, we've been that way all year. We've had a lot of balance. It is a team effort. We have, like Kelly Fitzgerald, for instance. He's a fine ball player.
She also played marvelous defensively tonight.
Yes, he's a good defensive ball player. Unselfish. And I think this is what makes you a good team ball player. I can't say enough about it. I can mention them all. I know you don't have time.
Well, Pete, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Hilliard.
Best wishes, thank you. Pete Pritchett, the coach of the new state champions, Bedford North Lawrence, and back to Jerry.
Thank you, Hilliard. Jerry Baker speaking for Hilliard Gates and Cinder Brado. Enjoyed it very much. And a reproduction of our telecast, strictly forbidden without the express written permission of the Indiana High School Athletic Association, who also has approval of the announcers we use in our telecast. Final score again, Bedford North Lawrence, 55, Crown Point 50. Congratulations to the new state champions, Bedford North Lawrence. So long, everybody.
Hey, Thomas.
You've been watching another Indiana High School Athletic Association championship event. Your network hosts have been Farm Bureau Insurance and the nearly 700 Farm Bureau Insurance agents located throughout the state of Indiana. And American Fletcher National Bank, providing stability and professionalism in banking.